According to Heidi Zikereta, the Rubanda District Tourism Officer, the industry is threatened by unemployed youth who have resorted to begging and stopping tourist vehicles. He says communities along Kabale, Rubanda, Kanungu Road, through Ruhija to Windy Impenetrable National Park are the most threatened.
We have so many challenges concerning the communities where these tourist vehicles, whenever the guides are driving on this Ruhija Road, going to Kanungu or going to Windy Impenetrable National Park, that is Rushaga or in Kisoro, they have been stopped by these younger boys and girls begging for money, giving me my money, and which is not good, of course, and as far as tourism is concerned, tourism government is concerned. But sometimes when they stop them, they don't. Of course, guides don't stop, and these young children end up throwing them stones.
He has called on security and other stakeholders to collaborate in finding solutions to this challenge that is risking the progress of the sector.
Our people have not yet been sensitized about the importance of tourism in our area. When people have come in your place, they are your visitors. But the local communities are looking, they view them indeed as the foreigners, and they want to treat them as such. So there are incidents where you find that local people are almost abusing tourists. There are also incidents that are so common with kids, children being lined up on the roads asking, begging for money. And some of them are like, I want my money. They are not expressing the language very well, and they keep saying, I want my money. And this is a little bit disgusting. It's not a welcome gesture to tourists. So we have not yet done enough. I think we call upon the district tourism offices, to engage these people in dialogue, to go on radios and educate them.
Engineer Ivan Batuma Mbabazi, the chairperson for the tourism cluster in Chigezi sub-region, has called for engagements aimed at mindset change.
We need to keep on sensitizing the communities around the tourist destinations. Yeah, it is of course very bad for the communities to... they should be sensitized, mindset. There should be continuous engagement about tourists. Because as the tourists come here to relax, to enjoy the country, they shouldn't be bombarded with, give me money, give me this, give me that, and also to an extent of even stoning their cars. So that's really something we need to work together also with the enforcement, also tourism police, but mainly important is to mindset change so that these communities can see the value of the tourist.
The general guidelines were that most of the tourist companies and specifically accommodation areas and hotels, they are supposed to be guarded by our tourism police. If you have been going to some of these companies, you find that black, the counter-terrorism police in those hotels. And for a while, I've not registered in this region, we have not registered cases where the population have been violent against any tourists or tourists.
Chigezi sub-region is popular for being at the center of Uganda's tourism attractions, including Lake Winyonyi, Africa's second deepest lake, Windy Impenetrable Forest, a popular spot for mountain gorilla tracking in the region, as well as Muhabura Ranges, among many attractions. Stakeholders are worried that if communities keep hostile towards tourists, the numbers might drop. Story by Job Namanya for the news in Kabale.